H2O, and today we are back with some more Sims Free Play builds. So today we are going to be building a daycare for the toddlers. So as usual, I am going to start with the check-in center, and then that's going to be a bathroom. And I'm going to do another small manager's office like I did in the dentist. In my last video, and if you have not seen that video, please go check it out. It's really cool. And okay, let's continue. So now I am going to make a huge room over here, which is going to be the playroom for all of the toddlers. After that, I'm going to make a small room right there that goes about out to there. And that's going to be where the chefs, or at least the people that cook the food, can cook back there. After that, I'm gonna make a little bit of a smaller room over here. Still gonna be a little bit bigger. That's actually pretty big. And that's where the toddlers are gonna go eat. And then finally, there's gonna be this bigger room, which is gonna be where the toddlers sleep. Then I'm going to make a patio that goes from here. Oh, my tent is not worth more. Yay. All the way to here. All the way down. And then this small area. There we go. And then use these gold eastern wood fences to finish it off. And I will change the patio paving to gray slate to make it look kind of more like a back area instead of like a kind of patio area. I don't know. So now that we finished with that, we can start doing the floors. So for the front check-in room, I am going to do the yellow flower floors, and same for the bathroom. But then for the manager's office, I am going to do the, I think it's back, yep, it is, the black tiles. Then after that, for the bedroom and the main playroom, I'm going to use purple stars. Then for the kitchen area, I'm gonna use the lucky carpet. And after that, I will use the white tiles for the eating room. So now let's do the walls. So I will use rose garden walls for the manager's office and the bathroom. And then I will use pink dream hearts for the check-in area. After that, I will use the dotted lines that are red, I guess, for the kitchen and the eating area. And then for the sleeping and main play area, I'm going to use the space rockets. Okay, now let's move on to the doors over there. So, I would probably use the tan Scandinavian doors. Hope that's how you say it. And put them right in the middle over there. Then I'll use the designer door for the manager's office and the Neo Tokyo door for the bathroom. After that, to be able to get into the other room, I will go all the way back and add one single door, which will be right there. So then there is still room for the check-in office. So I will put that right over there. Okay. After that, I will add the double door for the sleeping room, or the sleeping area, and the boat door, which I think is over here, yes, for the kitchen area. Then after that, finally, I will go all the way back once again and use the single door for the area where the toddlers eat. And then just to be able to get into the backyard, I will add a tan Scandinavian door, which is a single. Oh, come on. These sometimes are hard to work. There we are. Okay, so now that we're finished with that, we can get to furnishing. So, I'm going to do the bathroom first. So, for the bathroom, I'm going to do this toilet with the kind of wood top, and then the double sinks. And for the double sinks, I am going to use the brown medium sink. There we are. And then I will do the manager's office, because that will be a quick place to do. And I will go use the home office laptop right over there. And of course, in pretty much every room except for the bathroom, because there is no room. Well, actually, yes, with it open, I will add lights. So then they can be bright, nice and bright. So now in the bathroom, I'll add the box wall lamp, which will be right there. Done. Okay, so now for the check-in area. For the check-in area, I like to go to the counters and go all the way down until I find the Neo Tokyo. So then, for this one, I do it right there. I turn it. Then, I place it like this. And yes, it is not the best way to do it, but this is the way that I like to do it. For this build. And then I turn this one around again. And I'll just copy this one. Done. Then after that, just to make sure that there's no weird empty spaces like there is right now, I would add the Scandinavian floor lamp, which is right over here. And then say that one of your Sims could go in there, because they can't, but say that they could, I would add any kind of foam, but I recommend the ET foam. Okay, so now that that room is pretty much done, it is a really simple room, but still, it's really nice, I will go into the toddler section of the home store, and I will just start adding tons of fun things for the toddlers to do. Like this rocking unicorn, and I will also add a rocking horse. Just so then, it's not only a girl's area, boys can play with this too. I will add a fairy tale tea set. I'll put it right. And then I will also add a blackboard. Is that the right way? Yeah, I think it goes both ways. A toy stroller. Car tracks. Car racing tracks. Dollhouses. A bookshelf, and I will make it a play block bookshelf, and I will place it right about there. So then, as you can see, this place will be pretty crowded because there will be a lot of things for the toddlers to do. And then I'll add the play block. Then that is how the room looks. Then, of course, I need to add the lights. So I will add this sci-fi floor lamp right over there. Okay, now onto the kitchen area, because that is a pretty simple part of this build. So I will go all the way down again to the countertops. To the Neotopia and use this one. And I will place it every one kind of block. So I'll place one there, there, and one there. Then after that, I will go to the kitchen and get the dinner oven. I will keep on copying that. I get all the way down, like that. Then just to make sure that there is at least one light in there, I will add a retro table lamp on the last countertop, so just away from the door. So now that we have all those rooms done, I usually like to go back to the toddler section and go all the way down again until we get to the nursery dining table and nursery dining chair. So what I like to do is I like to add one dining table there and another one there. Maybe a little bit further. Perfect. And then I like to add the dining chairs. The nursery dining chairs. So I will keep on adding these in until we fill up all of the tables, and I only do the front and the back. Okay, so now that we're done with that, we'll go to the bedroom, the final inside part, and add the pink race car beds, two of the pink race car beds, and two of the red race car beds. Okay, finally, this one more light. I'll add a stylish tall lamp for this one. Okay, now finally on to the outside patio. I will go back to the toddler section and I will add the toddler playhouse over here. I will add a rainbow seesaw, and a swing set. And that is all we need for that area. Finally, on back to the house section, and go on to the exterior walls. For the exterior walls, I like to go all the way down and add the pink brick. Finally, for the roofing, I like to add the red roof. So then it looks like that. Okay, that's it now. So please make sure to leave a like and subscribe. And I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.